Okay, good evening once again. Let's start this. Now, as you know that this particular session is titled as option elimination, right? In the last 3 to 4 classes, what we have seen, okay, the method which we are discussing, that's it's not a conventional approach to solve a question. Whether it's a value putting, whether it's identifying the pattern, or it's option elimination. These are the methods to sharpen your tools so that you get yourself ready for the aptitude exams like CAT. We haven't taken any conventional classes, right? We haven't taught you any topics, but we have dealt with some of the approach and technique so that you can ace your exam in a more better way. So with this, we are going to start our last session, which is option elimination. Now, as the name suggests, what we are going to do is we will be dealing with the, we will try to solve the question using the options given. Now, this session will be definitely be helpful for those students who are somewhat weaker in maths. And if they don't know the conventional approach to solve a question, they can actually apply this particular method that to arrive at the right answer by eliminating the wrong options. So with this, let's start the session. The first two questions, I'll be taking that as an example to demonstrate you that how we are going to apply the option elimination method. And for the next questions, I'll presume that you will be able to solve that particular question by understanding what I have demonstrated in the first two questions. So let's start the solving session, guys. Wait a minute, I'm sharing the content. Now, is the board visible to everyone? Okay, so let's start with the easiest of the lot. This question, the question says, I will demonstrate this particular question so that you can get to understand that how they're going to eliminate options to arrive at the right answer, right? Okay, so this particular question says, okay, there are two friends, Bondu and Cuckoo, who have a salaried that jointly amount to rupees 10,000 per month. Now we got to know that okay, the salary of Bondu and Cuckoo jointly, it amounts to 10k, right? Now let's go to the other statement given in the question. Found monthly, and it is found that the ratio of their saving is 4:3. Then which of the following is Bondu's salary? This is the question which is being given. Now obviously this question could have been solved with the conventional approach, but I'm trying to make you understand a different approach to solve this particular question. Now let's think that what we can do, how we are going to eliminate the options. It's been given that the combined salary of Bondu and Cuckoo is 10,000. Okay. Now they spend the same amount. The spawn amount spent by Bondu and Cuckoo are same. This is same. Equal. But despite of that, the savings of Bondu and Cuckoo are given the ratio of 4:3. Now, if I'll ask you, who saves more? So the answer is Bondu, right? Reason being saving is 4:3 and Bondu saves more. That is, then it's asking that which of the following could be the Bondu's salary, right? Now their spending are equal and the saving of Bondu is more than that of Cuckoo. That means that the earning of Bondu must be greater than that of Cuckoo, right? They spend the same amount, right? But the ratio of their savings is 4:3, which means that the ratio in which they are earning, that has to be Bondu salary must be, right? Now, we know that their combined salary is 10K. Now look into the options. If the combined salary is 10K and we got to know that Bondu's salary is more than Cuckoo's salary, वी कैन इजिली से दैट कि भोजू सैलरी मस्ट बी ग्रेटर देन 5,000, राइट? नाउ लुक इन टू द ऑप्शन गिवन. देर इज ओनली वन ऑप्शन विच इज मोर देन 5,000, एंड वी कैन से दैट ऑप्शन ए कैन बी द भोजू सैलरी एंड ए इज द आंसर फॉर इट. सो हाउ वी हैव अप्रोच दिस पर्टिकुलर क्वेश्चन? No conventional method, no formation of equation. What I'm trying to do is that their combined salary is given. If their savings of Bondhu is more than that of Cuckoo, in that case, the earning of Bondhu should be more than that of Cuckoo. And if the earning of Bondhu is more than that of Cuckoo, that has to be greater than 5,000. Now look that what are the options available? We can see that there is only one option in which the salary is more than 5,000, that is 6,000. That is the direct answer. You got it, everyone, that how we have approached this particular problem? Shall we proceed to the next question, guys? In a similar manner, that we have eliminated the option by getting the condition that the Bondhu salary must be more than that of 5,000. We can easily approach and solve the other question. Let's see that how we are going to approach the questions. Now, question number 2 says 10 to the power 22 minus 45 is divisible by. Now, while you are solving a question by option eliminated method, you need to see the options given, right? Now, the options here are, just look minutely into the options given. Option A says 3, B 9 and 3, C 11, and D 3, 9 and 11. Now we can see that 3 is available in all the options except C, right? So intelligence says that let's check it out whether the given is divisible by 3 or not. Okay, if it is not divisible by 3, I can directly mark the answer as C. So let's check that whether the given expression is it divisible by 3. Now how we are going to check this? 10 can be represented as 3 plus 1, 3 chi square minus 45 upon 3, right? This 45 is perfectly divisible. So we got to know that this will result in a remainder 1. This particular than 3 square is divisible by 3. So we'll be left with 1 as a remainder, right? So we can say that this particular number is not divisible by 3, right? This is not divisible by 3. Now, if 3, I can easily say that option A, option B, and option D will be eliminated then. So in that case, even I don't need to check that whether the given number is divisible by 11 or not. As I have said that the 3 are available in all the options, and we have checked this by 3, and we have found that this particular number is not divisible by 3. In that case, we can directly mark the answers as 11. Getting a point, guys? So you need to understand this. While solving the questions by option elimination, you need to be have that knack so that you can be very, very minutely looking into the options, that what could be which could be eliminated there and then, and what could be the possible options which we will take up further to eliminate it. Got it, guys? These two examples. Okay. Now let's try to solve question number 3. I'll wait for the next 2 minutes. Let's try solving this particular question number 3, and we'll understand that how we are going to put the options and check. I'll be waiting for the next 2 minutes for your answers. Okay, I'm going to repeat the second question. The second question number two, this is being asked as 10 to the power 22 minus 45 is divisible by, and there are four options given. Now, when you look into the options given, what you will find that 3 is available in all the options except option C. So, using our intelligence of option elimination, what I can do is I can directly check that whether the given number is divisible by 3 or not. If the given number is not divisible by 3, then option A, B, D will be directly eliminated, right? So the first option, the first number which I'm going to check that the whether the given number is divisible with or not will be 3. Now I'm going to check that. We know that 10 to the power 22 minus 45, this particular expression, I just need to check that this number is divisible by 3 or not. Now, anyone who knows the simple the divisibility, they can easily break this expression as 10 to the power 22 can be written as plus 1 power 22 plus 45 upon 3, right? Now, look into this particular expression. What you can see that, this particular 45 is divisible. This particular expression will be left as 1 as remainder. Now, for this, you just need to know the little bit of tits and bits of remainder theorem. So, this particular number is not divisible by 3 actually, and this will leave 1 as a. You can understand this like this way, that if I'll say that 10 to the power 500, is it divisible by 3? So, I'll say this is not divisible. Getting a point, as we can check that if I divide 10 by 10 will leave the remainder 1. So like this whole expression when divided by 3 will leave. Now you got it, guys? So and I found that this particular expression is actually not divisible by 3, right? So in that case, option B and option D is directly eliminated, and we don't answer, right? So we can mark C as an answer and we can move further to the next question. Okay, let's solve this question number 3 now. Any answer for this question, guys? Now, I'll be explaining you that how we're going to use this option elimination technique for solving this particular question. Question number three. Now, what this question says, actually, this is a CAT question. This question says that cities A and B are in different time zone. Now, there are two cities and they are in different time zone. A is located 3000 kilometer east of B. So what I can say that the distance between B and A is located 3000 kilometer east, and the distance between them is 3000, right? Okay. Now what's been given in the question? The table below describes the schedule of an airline operating non-stop flights between A and B. All the time indicated are local and on the same day. Okay, assume that the plane's cruising speed in both direction. However, effective speed is influenced by east to east at 50 km/h. The speed of the wind is given, which is 50 km/h. Now, definitely, this speed of wind has an impact on a speed of plane, right? In the journey. On the overall journey, as we can see that we need to calculate the relative speed in that case. Okay. Now it's blowing from the east to west at 50 kilometer per hour. What is the speed of the plane? Now this we need to find it out. Now let's look into the table first. It's like the plane departs city B at 8 a.m. and then for city A it reaches 3 p.m. There's a different time zone, but definitely the plane departs city A at 4 p.m. which means that there is a halt of 1 hour in their time zone, but definitely there is a halt of 1 hour, right? And it arrives city B at 8 p.m. Now if I look into the overall journey, how much time it took from B to A and A to B in terms of B time zone? It's the plane departs at 8 a.m. and arrives at 8 p.m. The total time taken is, with the time zone of B, the total time taken is 12 hours, right? But 12 hour, because there is a halt of 1 hour. The plane arrives city A at 3 p.m. and departs at 4. So there is a halt of 1 hour, right? So we can say that your total time journey is 12 hour. We can need to subtract 1 hour. That is 11 hour is the total time journey, right? Okay. Now this is the time. Now let's consider the speed of the plane as x. And we write this equation that when it goes in the direction of the wind, the time taken will be, let's take the speed of the plane is s plus 50, and when it goes into against the direction of wind, the time taken will be, so the speed of the plane will be s minus 50, right? The relative speed, we know that the concept. Okay, if we are the same thing which you used to apply in upstream and downstream motion, right? So looking into the question, we can see this particular equation. Agree, a total journey of 12 hours considering time zone of B, the plane departs at 8 a.m. and arrives at 8 p.m. the total time is 12 hours. But I need to subtract 1 hour. Reason being, the plane arrives A at 3 p.m. and leaves at 4 p.m. So I need to subtract 1 hour. So total time is 11 hour. Now, we know that the speed of the wind is 50 kilometer per hour. So when the plane is moving along the direction of the wind, the relative speed will be S plus 50, considering S as the speed of the plane. So the total time taken will be, in that case, will be 3000 plus s upon 50. And when it moving against the direction of the wind, the time taken will be 3000 upon s minus 50. Now, do I need to solve this equation to arrive at the answer? directly put the value of s from the options given. And we can see that if you're going to solve this equation, this could take 1 to 2 minutes extra time, right? So we can directly put from the options given. We'll see that there is only one option which satisfied. I just need to put the value of s, and we'll see that this will arrive at the 11. 3000 upon 550 plus 50, 600, and 550 minus 50, that will be 6 plus 5, 11 will be the answer. 11 will be the total time taken. So we can directly say that without calculating this particular equation. Now we can see that option elimination helps us while solving the question. This also helps us in reducing the number of steps, right? So this could be taken as another technique to reduce the number of steps. We can directly go to the option and we can find that, okay, there is only one option which satisfies the condition, that is 550, and that has to be the answer. Got it, everyone? Shall we move to the next question? Okay. I hope you are learning the technique. For the next 1 to 2 question, you are going to apply your mind so that you can be able to grasp this particular technique to your spine level, and you will be able to solve some question in a very unconventional manner, right? Okay, just wait. I'm sharing the sheet. Okay, sheet visible, guys? Question number 4. Using the option elimination technique. I'll be waiting for the next 1 to 2 minutes so that you can be able to solve this question. And then we will discuss. Solve, guys. Now, it's like, I'll just give you some hint that if two numbers are in, given that harmonic mean, if I take the two numbers as AB, the harmonic mean between the harmonic mean will be 2AB upon A plus B. Okay. Harmonic mean of two natural number AB will be 2AB upon A plus B, and geometric mean is, if the two numbers are A and B, the geometric means are root AB. Now, if you don't know the concept or anything, the formula, I have disclosed that. Now, let's try to solve this question using the options. Sorry, there was some problem. I'm explaining it again. Okay, I have considered the number as AB. I got to know that the harmonic mean is 2AB upon A plus B, and geometric mean is AB, root under AB. Now, we know that the ratio is being given as 12 is to 13, right? So, we can solve this further to obtain that root AB upon A plus B is equal to 6 upon 13. Now, we don't need to solve it. Just compare the numerator and denominator. What you'll find? In numerator, AB, the product has to be equal to 36. And in denominator, A plus B has to be 13. Now, look into the options given. We'll see the option number C. If I consider the number as 4 and 9, then the product of the number will be equal to 36. And the sum will be equal to 30. So we can easily say that the answer for this particular question is C, 4 is to 9. Got it, guys? Again, like the previous question, we started with the solution. And after just one step, I'm just checking with the options. That what are the options available? And I got to know that, okay, root AB upon A plus B has to be 6 upon 13. Now for that, the AB has to be 36, A into B has to be 36, and A plus B has to be 13. Now, looking into the option, I find that, okay, the option C satisfied, that if I take the ratio as 4 is to 9 or the number as 4 and 9, I can find that the product will be equal to 36 and the sum of the number A plus B will be equal to 13. Got it, everyone? Okay, question number 5 is easy. Let's try to solve this. Let's see that who's going to answer it first. Now, if you don't know that how we're going to solve this particular series, same thing, we'll be applying the option elimination. Like this is given that the series is like 1 upon 1 into 2 plus 1 upon 2 into 3 plus 1 upon 3 into 4 up to n terms. It's been asking that what is the sum of the series, summation of the terms, right? Now, if I take n is equal to 1, now I'm talking about the only the first term, right? In that case, from the series, we got to know that this will be equal to 1 upon 2, 1 by 2, right? If you put the n is equal to 1, we'll get to know that this has to be 1 upon 2. Now, in that case, option B is eliminated. Eliminate the option cleverly, right? Now, when you put n is equal to 2, I'll be left in the series as 1 by 2 plus 1 upon 6. Which is equal to 2 upon 3. Now, when I put the value of n as 2, I get the sum of the series as 2 upon 3. So, let's check from the options that while putting the value of n as 2, whether I'm able to eliminate the options or not. Option A will become 1 upon 3. The value of n, if I put 2, this will be 1 upon 3. And this can be eliminated, right? Similarly, option C, if I put the value of 2, this will be 1 upon 2 into 3, that is 1 upon 6. This can be again eliminated. But when I put the value of n as 2 in option number D, this will become 2 upon 3, which is the obtained sum, right? So we can directly say that this is the answer without knowing the conventional approach that how we are going to solve this particular question. I can easily go through the options, putting the values, checking the options, eliminating the options, and arriving at the right answer. Got it, guys? Okay, now these two questions, question number 6 and question number 7, these two are somewhat challenging one. Let's see that how many of you guys will apply this option elimination to arrive at the right answer. Yeah, correct, Mishta. Very good. Let's solve question number 6 first, guys. I'll be waiting for you in the next 2 minutes. Solve question number 6. Sorry, Mishta, you said the answer B, right? B is not the correct one. Let's try it once more. Abhinav, you got it correct. Good. Let's try it, guys. Let's try to find it out how we are going to solve this particular question using option elimination method. Okay, I'll just give you a hint, some hint. Like what's given in the question, the sum of four consecutive two-digit odd integers when divided by 10 becomes a perfect square. Now, it's like the number has to be divisible by 10. Now, in that case, the unit digit of the number must be 0, right? Now, four consecutive two-digit odd integers. If that digit is an odd integer, the last digit can be, four consecutive digits can be 1, 3, 5, 7. Or in the same way, this could be like 3, 5, 7, 1. I'm talking about the last digit, right? The number is of two-digit number, odd number. Since the number is a consecutive odd number, so the last digit could be like 1, 3, 5, 7 or 3, 5, 7, 9, and so on. Okay. Now get a combination for which the sum of the last digit, the sum of the unit digit will be equal to 0. Now I've given you ample of hint. Now think for the next 30 seconds, guys. The only combination which is possible is 7, 9, 1, and 3, whose sum will be, the last digit will be 0 in this case, right? And that if it is divisible by 10, the number has to be a perfect square, right? Now we can think in this term that the unit digit of those consecutive two digit odd numbers can be 7, 9, 1, and 3, which is the only possibility, right? So we can directly eliminate option B first. Which of the following possibly can be one of these four integers? I can got to know that B can't be the answer for this question, definitely. Okay, now think further. Let's look into this option. Look into this option. Try to find it out that how we are going to eliminate the option. Next 30 second thing. I have marked two options, right? Now let's look for this one. You can also look for this one. Let's look for this one. If I take 41 as an option, if 41 as a number, what could be the other number? If I take 41 as one of the number, what could be the other number? Anyone? This could be 37. Good. 37, 39, 41 and 43. Now sum it up. You'll obtain 160, right? Now bingo, you got the answers. Now you can also check for 21. In that case, the number won't be a perfect square. If you divide by 10, the number won't be a perfect square. Okay, so 160, when divided by 10, the number is 16, and 16 is the perfect square of 4. So, did you see that how we have solved this particular question using, right? This is one of the important step when you're tool and technique when you're preparing for CAT, that you need to be it's like we used to say that you need to sharpen your tool when you're preparing for an aptitude exam. So by eliminating the options, we arrive at the answer that the option for this answer for this question is C. Try for the other options and you'll get to know that case the when you the sum can be the last digit can be zero, but the sum if divided by 10 won't be a perfect square in the other options, and we can easily eliminate all the other options given. Got it? Okay, let's see, let's try question number 7, guys. A very good question. Let's see that how many of you are able to solve this particular question using the option elimination method. Mishta, good. Correct one. I'll be waiting for you guys the next 2 minutes. Try to think that how we're going to solve this particular question using the option elimination. Let's look into the conditions given. Did you get any hint, guys? Yes, Shivani, good. Answer is D. But divisible by 3 can be 54 and 75 too. If you are applying that logic, how we will be able to eliminate option A and B? Exactly, the number has to be divisible by 12. Do I explain this? Okay, let's see what's given in the question, right? It says three natural numbers P, Q, R. In AP, the condition given is P is less than Q and Q is less than R. The first condition, and we got to know that K, P, Q, R are in AP. So, what I can say that K, if a common difference is D, P can be written as Q minus D. As we know that P is less than Q and R can be written as Q plus D. Okay. Now let's look into the conditions given. The next condition given is whereas 6P, 15Q, and 40 are in GP. Now, if three numbers A, B, C are in GP, what do you do? That in that case, B, common ratio has to be equal. That is, in that case, B square will be equal to AC, right? On a similar fashion, what are you going to know? Okay, in this case, if 16P, 5Q, and 40R are in GP, then 15Q whole square that has to be equal to 6P into 40R, right? Now, what I can do, okay, put the value of P and R in this equation. And proceed. Get the value of Q in terms of D. PQR, all the value of PQR in terms of D. But you'll find that P plus Q plus R, that will be equal to 12D. Substitute the value of P and R in this equation and find the value of PQR in terms of D. What will see, P plus Q plus R will be equal to 12D. Or in other word, the number has to be, the sum P plus Q plus R has to be a multiple of 12, right? Now go through the options given. Only one option available, that is multiple of 12, that is 60, and we can say that this is the right answer. We can easily eliminate option A, B, and C. Got this, guys? With these examples, I just tried to show, demonstrate that question can be solved using the options elimination method. That if I'm and it could be helpful in two ways. Either you are solving completely using the option, or this particular option elimination method you are applying in a midway of your solution and not solving the question completely till end. You solve the question for the first 2 to 3 steps, check the options, that which of the options satisfy the condition, and in that way we'll be able to eliminate the option and arrive at the right answer in a very less time. I hope you got this technique, guys. That's all for today's class. So with this, I hope you have well understood the value putting, the option elimination, the pattern recognition, the mental maths, which is a very, very prerequisite when you are preparing for exams like CAT, where aptitude definitely matters, but again, the attitude with which you solve the question matters a lot. Okay, thanks a lot, guys. Thank you, everyone, for attending the session.